It was a story that made national headlines. Four elderly passengers dead on board a Holland America cruise ship. The cause of death for two of the victims, COVID-19. Lynn Remly of Boston Heights, one of the passengers on board.
But a friend of mine who is a retired nurse said, well, there's only one case in South America, and that's in Brazil. It wasn't going anywhere near Brazil. So, you know, having made all of my preparations, I just decided to go.
Something the 77-year-old retired professor now regrets. Remly boarded the Zaandam cruise ship on March 7th in Argentina. What was supposed to be a two-week vacation turned into four.
The first port I got off at was on about the 14th, I think, of March, and that was Punta Arenas in Chile, and I had been there before too, but I did want to see it again.
But soon after, ports were being shut down after news of several passengers falling ill.
The captain announced on about, I think, March 26th, give or take, that quite a number of people had been presenting themselves at the medical center with flu-like symptoms.
The ship remained at sea with passengers quarantined in their cabins. Holland America sending another ship to the Panama Canal, bringing medical supplies and taking healthy passengers on board.
I have asthma and a history of pneumonia and also allergies, so I do have lung problems.
After a battery of tests to confirm she was COVID-19 free, Remly and other passengers finally docking in Florida, then boarding a flight to Cleveland, returning on Friday. Now in self-quarantine, Remly only leaves her house for daily walks. Future travel plans now on hold.
You always have the feeling that you can at least rent a car and come home. It's quite a different feeling being stranded and separated from home by a couple of thousand miles of water.
Jennifer Jordan, Fox 8 News.